Behind me is a lime green equipment hauling machine. It's an LPX that a contractor got on diamondc.com and purpose built to get the job done for him. Let's go take a look at it, see what standard features plus the options he put on it that makes it the perfect trailer for them. Like all the models that Diamond C offers, the LPX has a wide variety of options to make it your own. It starts at a 16-foot bumper pool with 14,900 GVWR, and you can build it all the way up to a 30-foot gooseneck with a 24,000 GVWR. So today, the one that this contractor built was specifically for hauling like heavy concentrated equipment to and from the job site. Mini X's, skid steers, maybe in the 11, 12,000 pound range and still need a little extra capacity for accessories or attachments. This one is a 26 foot overall. You can see we have it paired with an F550 with a flatbed. To kind of give you that visual, this is the type of truck that a contractor would use, whether it's a, you know, a concrete contractor, or it's a landscape contractor, or even just general construction. These are the type of rigs that they're putting it with. So at the front, this one, he chose the engineered gooseneck package. The gooseneck package is great because when you're hauling that concentrate equipment, it does distribute the weight of the load further up the frame of the truck, towing better, some say it backs better. And then, as we all know, if you have a trailer, you suddenly have many, many new best friends that want to borrow it, and a gooseneck kind of deters that a little bit. It does come with the full width storage box between the neck, tons of room for chains, binders, blocks, you name it, the type of stuff you would need. And the box is lockable to keep sticky fingers off of it. Comes with dual jacks. That's something that we decided long ago. You'll see where you can save money with another brand and they'll keep it down to one jack and maybe a small toolbox and the one jack's in the center. But we decided many years ago that one jack in the center on a trailer of this caliber is, when you're talking about only saving a few hundred bucks, is super cheap and it's a terrible customer experience. Dual jacks is the only way to go. That way, if you get in a bind, need to unhook, you're not, you know, breaking your back on one jack. He also chose the LED load light option. It's great for guys that are, you know, they're working before the sun comes up, they're grinding past sundown. There are 2,000 working lumens each side. We sell them in a pair. They have a switch on them to operate independently. You can turn them out to the side. You can, they're just, they articulate all different directions, so making your work that much easier. Moving back, they selected the 36-inch deck step. Makes getting on and off the trailer that much easier, you know, when you're accessing or having to access your equipment that's on the deck. Backing up to another feature of the gooseneck package, it comes standard with this chain tray that reaches all the way across the neck. Cool thing is you throw chains, binders, things in there for quick access, you know, to and from the deck, but it also doubles as a winch mount. It has this plate cover that comes from the factory, and if you never mount a winch there, cool, no harm, no foul, that plate stays there. But if you want to mount a winch there, there's already a bolt pattern in the bottom of the tray where you can mount your winch directly into the tray. You take this cover off, mount your fair lead, and then you can run your power and mount your battery in the box. It's pretty cool. Or it actually comes with this receiver tube as well, and you can mount a winch on a receiver plate, slide it in, put a pin in to where it is removable. So either way, super versatile piece that comes in the engineered neck package. For ultimate tie-down capability, he chose the rub round stake pocket option, which is a 2x3/8 flat with big quarter inch stake pockets, the full length of the trailer in front and behind the fender. That way you can have a spot to chain down pretty much anywhere. It also comes with 4 of the 5/8 D-rings for chaining down your equipment standard. Another option he selected is the fork holders. You see these two slots in the side of the frame. It's pretty cool because you don't have to use up deck space to haul a set of forks. Because say you've got a skid steer that you've got a grapple and a bucket and a set of forks, and you want to get it all to the job site at one time, you can simply slide your forks in these two pockets, throw a strap around them. They will stay there. The mast rides up against the rub rail. Then you still have your deck space up front to put your grapple or your other attachments while the bucket stays on the skid steer or whatever combination of attachments you need to get to the job site. Your forks can always slide in the side super easy and be secure. This LPX was configured with the 208 package. That's 2 8K axles, giving us a GVWR of 18,000 pounds. This trailer also weighs dry weight 5,000 pounds, so we have a 13,000 pound useful payload capacity, which matches up really well with this contractor and what he's setting out to do. If you have, say, an 11,000 pound skid steer, which is pretty common these days, that gives you about 2,000 pounds extra of payload, whether that's other attachments, for your chains and boomers. I mean, all the things you would need to get to the job site, it gives you a little extra capacity. The 208 package also comes with a 215-17.5 wheel and tire combination. It's a 16 ply tire, which is super heavy duty. It's a regroupable tire. The 16 ply comes in handy because, you know, you're on these job sites and there's no telling what you may encounter. So 16 ply, super puncture resistant, gonna last a long time, a high mileage tire. Part of the 208 package, any package on the LPX above the standard, it triggers the engineered beam. And you can see how the frame kind of contours up right here, up to the suspension. And what that's showing you is we have complete control over the shape of the I-beam frame, the height, the thickness of the material. We're able to put the material where it counts the most for the strength per the weight rating of the trailer, the length of the trailer, all of those things. This is the same technology that we pioneered 4 or 5 years ago in the F-Max series, the much heavier flatbed gooseneck series of trailers. It keeps the weight down and the strength off the charts. One of my favorite options, bar none, that we have available on the website is the 3/16 Super Duty fenders. If you pay an ounce of attention going down the road and look on job sites, the fenders on those trailers are usually trash. And it's pretty common. I mean, when you have hands running equipment or you have your employees, you know, running the truck and trailer, they're there to work. And the fenders usually take a beating, whether they hit something with the trailer or they hit the fenders with equipment. The 3/16 fenders, man, if you hit something with these, whatever you hit is going to be torn up worse in most cases than the fender itself. These are super stout. The last feature we're going to look at is the loading option that they chose. On the LPX, you have a slide-in option available, you have a stand-up ramp option available, then you also have the max ramps, which is what they chose. The max ramps are cool because they give you a nice wide loading footprint. When they're both down, you can load a variety of equipment on it and not have to slide them in and out, and gives you just a good sturdy footprint. You can see I have one in the up position and then one in the stowed position. The cool thing is with both of them in the stowed position, you can use the full length of the deck. So this one is 26 feet. If I'm hauling steel or supplies that I need to use this area as regular deck space, you can do so. They're awesome, like I mentioned, for loading equipment. Super easy to operate. I mean, just effortlessly gives you a nice gradual loading approach up to the deck. And then as this one is standing up, if you have something that, say, you're loading a tractor with a cutter on it, or you need to be able to hang over the dovetail area, they come with a bar. It'll stand up on its own. They come with a bar where you can actually pin them in the up position to be able to use this area. It's not just void. Jump on diamondc.com, and there you can build an LPX to fit your style, whether you're a farmer, contractor, you name it. LPX, tons of different options available to make one your own. We'll see you on the road.